And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later on for some Golgari Midrange. So this was a 5-0 list that was published the other day that looks pretty sweet that I wanted to try out because we have a War of the Spark card that I was always interested in playing but just never really played it too much, and that's Deathsprout. And we got four of them in here, and I'm pretty excited about that. Hey, what's up, Angry Ben? So yeah, basically we have, you know, like we're ramping here with our Land War Elf Paradise Druid, getting our mana creatures in here just like every other green deck in the format. That's where you start, four of each of those cards. And we're getting to this top end where we're just continued, like our mid game we're ramping more Deathsprout, destroy a creature, get a basic land put into play, Cavalier Thorns, you know, look at the top five, put a land into play. And we got our 12 basics. Oh, I didn't fix the basics in this one. Just like the Nye Feather. Forgot to fix the basics. And then, yeah, we have our top end of Carnage Tyrants and Liliana's, which those cards are definitely some very good cards. I like how with the Carnage Tyrants, we do have all these fine finalities that we can get back our Carnage Tyrants. And especially like if the Cavalier Thorns is milling over some creatures, we can get them back with that. It does seem that like we're going to struggle a little bit against decks that can go wide and put up some defense for Carnage Tyrant. But that's what Liliana's for. Either, you know, ticking up and we just protect Liliana for the ultimate, or with the -4, making them sacrifice a couple of creatures. Hopefully that helps our Carnage Tyrant get through. And of course we have Finality. They can shrink a deck that's going wide and put counters on our Carnage Tyrant as well. So we got some pretty cool stuff in here. We can see how our sideboard is really targeted, you know, for Noxious Grasp, you know, for all the green and white decks, Ashiok for Scapeshift, Shifting Ceratops for control, and for the flash decks, and Massacre Girl for other green decks, like with mana creatures and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, so how does this deck win versus Scapeshift? I would assume we would want Ashiok, right, to help out there. But then also we have like the finalities that can kill all the zombies and put more counters on our Carnage Tyrants and attack in with that. That's what I would assume that we'd be doing here. Let's fix our basics. What do we need? We need 9 forest, 3 swamp. All right, 3 swamp, 1, 2, 3, and 9 forest. Okay, well, let's give this a try. All right, so I'm just gonna go ahead and play this deck in ranked also to try this one out here. We've been doing some rank today. The rankings just reset with it being a new month here. We got, you know, beginning of August. And so we got to work our way back up to Mythic. Man, I want to keep this one, but I probably shouldn't, but I want to. I kind of want to keep this. Like Jade Light hits more lands, we play a Deathsprout, we get another land. I'm gonna keep this. Yeah, I've been having fun with Ashiok recently too. I like Ashiok. Kinda wanna make an Ashiok Jace Tameo self mill deck. So as we were talking earlier in the stream about decks that don't rotate, you know, decks being built for post rotation, you know, with no cards that rotate, and how I'm planning on doing that, making decks for rotation like that. Do y'all think, so if I do that, do y'all think, like, with green decks, I should still put in Land War Elves, because it just, you know, just makes your green deck so much better, even though Land War Elves is rotating? Like, should I make that one, you know, it's a common and everything, should I make that one I don't know, what's it called? Yoraka Musum. That one exception. There we go. Should I make that one exception?
Those who cannot hone your prowess.
No, Land of Worlds won't be in standard unless it's in Throne of Eldraine, but that's unlikely.
I must train harder.
By Esper and Nissa's? Yeah, I mean, I definitely know that Esper is going to be, like, that's going to be, like, the hardest matchup, like, you know, decks with Kaya's Rats and stuff like that. That's going to be tough. Nissa's... I don't have the mana for this yet. Let's go graveyard. And then bring it back. I didn't really want to find back any of the mana creatures. Oh, I guess I had Jade Light Ranger to find back. I forgot about Jade Light. Yeah, I could Deathsprout my own Land of War to ramp up, but we'll just save it. We'll Deathsprout that thing. I want to do that right now. Or would I rather play one of these things? Playing Teemer Elementals again. I could do that sometime soon. Maybe that'll probably be a deck that I'll make for next week. Like I said, I'm planning on making rotation proof decks. They're not going to be as good as normal standard decks, you know, because we're only using half the card pool, but yeah, making an elemental deck with that certainly would make sense. Also, I don't think it's worth it to leave Narset with one counter and do one extra damage to them. I just don't think that that's really worth it. I mean, we could have Liliana that would draw us extra cards or something. It's just not really worth leaving the Narset there. I don't know what's going to happen with it, but so I'm not able to play both Deathsprouts here. Really, we need to find Assassin's Trophy to destroy this Ascanta. This Ascanta is just going to wreck us up pretty good. Thanks so much for that Twitch Prime sub, Black Geppetto. Everybody get your hype in the chat there. For our resub, our 8th sub of the day and 8 months for Black Geppetto also. I guess I do like Cavalier of Thorns with Find Finality, come to think of it. That is a really nice combination, how, you know, Cavalier of Thorns dies, so you put Find Finality back. Oh, but then you have to exile Cavalier of Thorns, though. So it doesn't work as well as I was thinking. Yeah, Dracky Seth Bond Revival is a nice combination. Main deck Noxious Grasp. That's obnoxious. I mean, I play main deck Noxious Grasp these days also.
This isn't a fight you can win. Trust me, I have a plan.
All right, I'm going to destroy both guard mages, let the Jade Light kill the little Teferi, and then attack them for 7. Pretty surprised they're not shocking in there, to be honest. Hopefully we'll stop drawing basics if we get some more basics in play here.
Should have seen that coming.
He's so unlucky with the Thorns, he always trash way too many good cards. Yeah, that's kind of a problem with Cavalier Thorns, but that's why the Find Finality actually works out really well with it. We just don't want to mill over any of our either of our Lilianas, really. That's the main thing that we don't want to mill over is Liliana. Meow, 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 meow. We'll see how many Kaya's Wraths they're playing. That's 2. Kaya's Wraths are got to be their only answers to Carnage Tyrants. Yeah, it does feel like Command the Dread Horde would be a card that we should be playing at the very least in the sideboard of this deck. I agree with you there. Command the Dread Horde does feel like it works really well with Cavalier of Thorns in particular. All right, well, maybe I should just put a Carnage Tyrant back on top anyway. Hoping they don't have 4 main deck Kaya's Wraths. So we're definitely hoping here.
No time for a break.
Sabotages have been pretty good for him. But they're pretty close to just seeing all the cards in their deck. Stop.
The path, I have just the trick for this.
Hurry.
All right, well,
meditate and prepare.
I made the wrong decision with the Cavalier Thorns of putting the Fine Finality back on top. I should have put Carnage Tyrant back on top, and then we would have had an extra Carnage Tyrant here. It's a lesson learned. And they would have forced them to have two Kaya's Wrath. Lesson learned. I got way too greedy with the Fine Finality, with it getting countered there. So that's my bad. They could just have the fourth Kaya's Wrath though, and we'd be in the same spot.
Trust me, you'll thank me later. That's more like it.
Esper doesn't always have counter spells. I would say that playing Sinister Sabotage's main, you know, is that the third sabotage we've seen? I'd say that that's not common. I'd say not very many decks have that. Oh, yeah. Forgot we got four of these things in here. So all I could do right now with Golgari Queen... I can't draw extra cards because of Narset. So all I could do is, like, kill Narset or Teferi with this thing. I honestly just don't think we can win from here with them having the sabotage and everything. Honestly, just don't think I don't think we have anything to draw. So why do people pass their turn then concede? Well, it takes some people a little bit of time to concede. You know, like the turn passes automatically if you don't have stuff to do.
I have reached my limit.
All right, so I think that was my fault. Got too greedy there with that Fine Finality. So basically everything but the Masker Girls in our sideboard can do work here. I'm not sure how much we really want Ashiok, but it can do work. Keeps like Ascanta from flipping and all that kind of stuff. Wow, yeah, we didn't see any of these trophies. But if we play all these and we don't play these, and do I just not play Cavalier Thorns? Is milling myself over bad? I can definitely No, I don't think I want to cut Golgari Queen. Do I need all this? I don't need all this removal. This is just too much removal. Okay, I'm gonna try this. Yeah, I could do the Ashiok Mill plan. I'm always a big fan of the Ashiok Mill plan. Yay. This deck has 26 lands, and we just saw one lander. Hooray. I do not want Trophy this early. Then which one of these six drops do I want to take back? Do I want to put back? I mean, I think the six drops are probably getting Thought Erasured away, just in general, anyway. Which I guess I'd rather that be Carnage Tyrant. Yeah, the Abzan Hero list is on my Stream Decker page. Yeah. Interesting. Certainly considering not playing anything and just seeing, like, if they don't draw land, they have to just go to discard again and, you know, just kind of, like, waiting and us filling our hand and just kind of, you know, having the waiting game. Certainly considering not playing anything, because whatever I play lets them play their Cast Down, Noxious Grasp, that kind of stuff. Dispark. Anything I play just lets them use their removal spells. I think I am just going to not play stuff. Alright, well punished. Yep. That was the only scenario that punished me for not playing stuff, is them having land Cry of the Carnarium. Yeah, we got punished real hard. Now they're drawing all the lands.
You should leave before I make you disappear. Flatter yourself. I've suffered worse.
They did definitely have the Noxious Grasps, as we saw there. The good news is we've gotten them down to just the three cards now. They kept the, whatever that card was, they kept it on top pretty quickly. So it's probably that Narset. Thoughtfulness before action.
Coming until it's too late.
Hey, 619. I'm very definitely glad they're using that and not killing Sarah, you know, Hey Ceratops for Teferi. We'll see if they have another one of those things.
I can no longer stand by and watch. This might be a bad idea.
So I think they have, like, they ditched a Kaya's Wrath earlier with Azcanta. I think if I play Carnage Tyrant, it probably gets Kaya's Wrath.
Let's skip to the good part.
Definitely hoping to kill this Hero of Dominaria. And I'm hoping this does it. Between the Cavalier and the Ceratops. Hoping they don't have two removal spells. Oh, right. They have instant speed, Kaya's Wrath. I guess that's a thing. Forgot about that. Called they had Kaya's Wrath.
Here goes nothing. We need to move quickly.
Knew they had Kaya's Wrath and just forgot about the whole instant speed thing. Played into that.
I know 88 ways to hone your prowess.
Gosh, why do I always get Fine Finality countered? I need to just stop getting Fine Finality and just keep getting Carnage Tyrant. Ugh, when will I ever learn with the Cavalier Thorns?
Here we go.
Certainly hope they don't see a third Kaya's Wrath. Oh, Liliana, never mind. That's game. All right, we got Esperd. Kaya's Wrath. Good card. Yeah. Sabotage gets to scry one, which is nice, you know. So yeah, I guess they like that more than the three life. I could definitely see that. I like the scry one. Remember, we were on a five-card hand there, so wasn't ideal. All right, not five cards. Thank you.
like to test a new hypothesis with you.
This whole four Deathsprout deck not looking great right now. Not looking very great right now at all. Facing Esper, then Nexus. Surveil is, yeah, Surveil is better than Scry. I think I like Scry more than Surveil, I think. But Surveil's a better mechanic. Like, it's more powerful. Well, nothing for me to do. So we need to find, like, we need to find, like, Assassin's Trophy, basically. Oops. I need
to the library.
Very good chance we're dead. Tamiyo is just so incredible in this deck. Getting rid of four cards a turn.
Seek and find.
So they have a bounce spell. They bounce the Cavalier. Then I'm dead. I'm already pretty dead anyway, though. Need to do damage to him. Alright, well, Root Snare is going to finish it off. We don't have any chance for winning. Any chance of winning from here. With Tamiyo grabbing another Root Snare and everything like that. Well, this doesn't look good for us. Wow, we have too many cards that don't matter. This deck does not have Nexus in mind. Don't know what this Ashiok's really going to do for me here. So it's like the goal is to get rid of win cons, I suppose. And hope the opponent concedes without having a win con. I mean, I guess the nice thing we'll find other lands. Nice thing about like this timer is that if we get rid of their win cons, then they can't just sit back. And Nexus forever until we get bored.
Beg for your life. It makes your night. Behold.
Yeah, the interaction that we have... No, I agree with that. The interaction that we have is not... It's just not good interaction for the matchups that we've been playing. Yeah, Ashiok will stop Ascanta from transforming. Cool. Got rid of those insights. They forgot to cast those, or just didn't cast them.
Your corpse will make a nice souvenir. An unfortunate casualty.
Another insight.
Dueling you will be excellent research. I know I noted this somewhere.
The fact that my opponent's not playing lands is a really bad sign for me. Because that means they probably have a lot more Nexus Fates. Which, all I did was just speed up their deck with Ashiok. I did not mill over and exile win conditions.
I think you will find my notes helpful.
Well, they're out of Chemist's Insights. But 22 cards left. Wow. No Nexus there?
Going to die anyway.
Unclear what our opponent's win condition is right now. Usually, especially post-board, it's like Nissa and... Put Tamio on the bottom.
This. My victory was but a dream.
It's possible that they may be expecting me to just concede kind of thing. It could just be Paradise Druid. That's all we've seen so far. They should be able to take the rest of the turns though.
Let me aid your research.
Oh, maybe not. There's Biogenic Ooze. It could just be that ooze. Wow.
Oh, I was getting bored anyway.
I leave you.
I will not stand for such violence.
Just like exiled all their lands.
You're making it difficult to work.
Okay, well,
to the library.
Do they have a win condition left? They get all the rest of the turns. So if they have a win condition, I lose. If they don't, then I win. We'll see if they were playing something besides that one Biogenic Ooze and the one Paradise Druid. So I don't get another turn. All they need is any win condition whatsoever. Ah, there we go. There's a win condition. Darn. They had another one in their hand. I want to kind of change up this Golgari midrange deck. Maybe I should just play another one, though. I don't like our... I don't know. Let's play another one. No, that's the thing. There's no duress. No veil. No duress. I don't really like not having Veil of Summer or duress. Well, Carnage Tyrant was going to be dead to... Carnage Tyrant was dead to the blast zone that they had. So Carnage Tyrant was not going to be able to block. They were going to be able to destroy it with blast zone. Finale could be fun. Yeah, there's a lot of different options you can go with Rakdos, midrange, and burn. You can check out my Stream Decker page there for some Rakdos decks. I haven't played one. Like, you'll have to, you know, like, scroll and look for it, or it's maybe easier to look on the YouTube channel for Rakdos decks. Haven't played in a little while, but got some Rakdos decks on there. want to shock so I can attack for one. Nah. Time to kind of find out about these death sprouts. No, I'm not planning on streaming Modern any again, Mountain. No, I sold my Modern collection. I sold my Magic Online collection and everything. I want a finality.
Magnificent world. Be wary of the ground you walk on.
Yay, no counter. And Vraska can turn these extra lands that we're getting into cards.
Don't dwell on what's about to happen.
Yeah, we're black green ramp.
Witness the ties that bind us all. The land shall conquer you.
Well, the death sprouts are kind of working out here. Playing against a creature deck.
Have at your best.
Our creature removal spell is good. It's a surprise, I know, but it's just happening. Darn. That's not good. Now we don't get to attack Nissa.
Being ruthless has its rewards.
So my plan, of course, is to Deathsprout the Deputy of Detention during combat and then be able to block a land.
Rise, my elemental friend.
I guess will be the Temple Garden, because that thing adds two.
things.
Casting Find into Explorer is not very good. I mean, I think Finality is gonna is more worthwhile than just getting a Jade Light. Like, that's not a good play. Now we have Find. We can grab, like, Carnage Tyrant and Jade Light. I don't know if we need to grab another Cavalier. Oh, we could grab another Cavalier Thorns. That could work. I guess maybe I should have Follied last turn. Nah. We can Folly now. Finality after Carnage Tyrant's definitely good. They can't steal Carnage Tyrant. That's weird. That's weird.
Sacrifices must be made. I leave the Golgari now. It's not often I'm outmaneuvered.
I thought for sure they were going to be fighting the Cavalier Thorns and killing the Cavalier Thorns. There's 26 lands in this deck. All right. Just got to kill lands over and over and over again. Can bring in all these Noxious Grasps and the Massacre Girls? Question mark. They, of course, have to have the mana creatures for Massacre Girl to... I don't even know if I really want Massacre Girl here. I guess the Ceratops does not get like Mass Manipulation or Entrancing Melody if they have those. If we take out Golgari Queen, that work? You think Massacre Girl is not good against Nissa? I thought Massacre Girl was good against Nissa if they make a bunch of lands. Play two queens still instead of two Paradise Druids. Frasco Golgari Queen is our mana dump. Like, that's why we have so many lands, because, you know, like, we're ramping and everything, and then with the extra lands, that's what we sacrifice them to Golgari Queen for the card advantage. We turn lands into card advantage. I don't know, I haven't, I don't, don't know if this deck's as good as Ebola Citadel deck. I don't know, I haven't been super impressed with this deck. We have some individually good cards and everything, but I haven't been super impressed with the deck yet. It's just Veil of Summer. Oh, I slow down. It's just obvious Veil of Summer. It's just not necessary for me to play this card here. I should just attack out. Wow, it doesn't get Veil of Summer. Never mind, that turn was great. You're welcome, Zinzin. Yeah, glad you're liking the Teamer Hydra deck. Yeah, I always like that deck too. That's one of my favorite decks. I would not kill this if I didn't have a backup removal spell. I need a removal spell for Nissa. So if I didn't have a backup for Nissa, I would not be playing that. I would not be killing that. Mm-hmm. Why do they want Shifting Ceratops against me? What about that game one made it seem like Shifting Ceratops would be a good card to play in this matchup? Where were they, like... Yeah, I understand my opponent's playing a bunch of Deathsprouts and Cavalier Thorns and Carnage Tyrants. All these cards they've seen, and they're like, you know what matches up well against any of those? Shifting Ceratops. It's terrible against all those cards. Where's the disconnect here? Didn't quite draw a removal spell there to win the game. There's Nissa. Power surges. Make a 3/3. Triceratops is better than T-Rex. Yep, I guess so. I guess everybody knows that.
The land fights for us.
So this specific list that I'm playing here, Sea Wookiees, was a 5-0 list that I wanted to try out. The 75 and everything. So I don't have like a reason not to have Nissa in here or anything like that. We're playing two more matches. We're playing five matches. Unless if we lose this next one and we're at 1/3, I'll probably just go to the next deck though. So if we win, we play another. If we lose, we're probably done. Let's get rid of the Deathsprout here. We don't have Deathsprout does cost double black. Don't have the second black yet, even though we could possibly get it. But we have a pretty good curve without it. Hey, works out. We'll get the Deathsprout back. I like getting double land off Jade Light with our opponent playing Watery Grave. Because against Watery Grave, we're going to need card advantage. I don't know exactly how long it'll take to hit Mythic. It resets every month. Not too long. It's nothing I'm really worried about. We're just playing Magic, having fun. That'll do. Opponent already got rid of one at Kaya's Wrath.
I am not going to keep up the pace.
There's a time not too long ago that everybody was playing Esper Hero. And they weren't playing Kaya's Wraths. It was a lot better for a little Carnage Tyrant. But nowadays everybody's playing like four Kaya's Wraths. And Liliana's. And it's made our life a lot worse.
You know what? I'm not done yet.
Yeah, not having Dreadhorde command or command the Dreadhorde in this deck has felt like there's just a lot of things in this deck that don't seem right.
Time to step out of the shadows.
So this is really awkward here.
Alive. For a life.
Really awkward with Golgari Queen, because
with each turn of the clock, your reality will crumble.
If I draw the card with Golgari Queen, then they could have Thought Erasure.
Mind and body. I have just the trick for this.
No, I didn't build this deck that we're currently playing. Yeah, I don't know. We haven't seen any of like the three Assassin's trophies. Yeah, no, we haven't seen those at all.
We will meet again.
I think that was a mistake by my opponent last turn. I think if I'm them, I would have played the Narset first, and then I would have Elderspelled away the Narset also to be able to keep the 5-mana Teferi around.
Right on schedule.
Good help is easy to find in war.
All right, another Kaya's Wrath ends it. All right, I'm going to play the Ashiok this time. We didn't play him last time. I'm going to play him this time. the last deck I sent you. All right, let me see what deck I sent you. I'll play Temple. No. Oh, okay, yeah. I understand. Okay, I will. I'll fix that. I know what you're talking about. So that's the problem with leading with the Overgrown Tomb. If I would have gone Temple first, then Temple Llanowar Elf would have had one of these to play right here.
I'm known for my excellent timing. No, I am not making this up as I go.
Seems fortune favors you. Its pain is our gain.
I think the Golgari Queen's probably dead to the spell hunt. Yeah, I think Scrylands are worth it. They didn't work out there for us, but I think overall they're worth it.
I can no longer. No time for a break.
All right, certainly hoping to draw a land. I'm assuming they have a Noxious Grasp here that's going to kill this Shifting Ceratops. And so we'd like the other Ceratops to be able to pressure the Teferi. Or we just have a Noxious Grasp. That'll do. Gosh, that's so gross. I could just treat it like a regular removal spell. Yeah, I guess they kept craving for all our mana creatures and everything.
Hold that thought.
Definitely hope no Liliana over there. I really struggle against Liliana. Oh, I didn't plus up Vraska to 5 the last turn. My bad. Yeah, another case of the temple holding us back, though.
An unfortunate casualty.
You know, having haste there would have been nice.
You know what? I'm not done yet.
Our gain.
Yeah, Golgari Queen would be at 9 if I would have ticked it up that other time. Alright, well, it wouldn't have mattered. Looks like they were tucking it either way, so. Didn't matter. Probably gonna run out of Kaiser at sometimes, right?
We need to move quickly.
Yeah, I'm not being Command the Dreadhorde. That is definitely the card that we talked about that I should be playing.
I know my responsibility.
I don't know, am I beating Command the Dreadhorde? I guess maybe I am.
I've got time.
They don't have another Kaya's Wrath. And if they don't have a counterspell. They have to have Kai's Wrath, Liliana, or... Yeah, gotta have one of those.
Hurry.
Or, like, another creature to help block. Another larger creature. You know, something that doesn't cost 3 or less for Golgari Queen to kill.
I've got it.
All right, so that Vincent Speed, Kai's Wrath.
I only pick targets that interest me. Lucky you.
This is hardly my worst defeat.
Well, on what's about to happen.
Well, that's their third Kaya's Wrath.
Sometimes sacrifice is necessary.
Frask Ultimate, not very useful whenever they're at such low life total anyway. It doesn't matter if I sack Tomb or Cemetery. There's no difference right now. As long as I keep one tomb.
Being ruthless has its rewards. Don't be surprised if we meet again.
That land was a good draw. I get to play this and have Memorial to Folly. That's good. Yeah, saw one Bell Haunt. Was hoping it's fine, like Liliana or Kaya's Wrath over there. Oh, I didn't. Darn it, I didn't Folly. That's Folly.
You're final.
Only
guess we're following the next turn.
Remember, your nightmares remain. I've lost my appetite.
All right, so down to one card. So do I go Carnage Tyrant to make it so only Kaya's Wrath and Liliana are good? Or do I go Ceratops, try to go for the haste kill? But then they, you know, they, if I go Ceratops, they need Mortify or Noxious Grasp. A tough call. Yeah, y'all are kind of like half and half. It is a tough call. I think since we've exiled three Kaya's Wraths, I'm going to go with the Carnage Tyrant. All right, well, they can gain life here.
Oh, I've done the hero thing before. This is hardly my worst defeat.
I'm just not going to worry about that card. Yeah, I guess I could have ultimated Vraska before, but
sorry I'm late. Let's try this.
We would not have... would not be as far down in the library as we are.
Fortune favors you.
It still doesn't save them. We need our opponent to draw millions of lands. And that finality came in clutch after they stole all of our creatures with Command the Dreadhorde. Definitely considering playing some Deathsprouts with us seeing, you know, Bellhaunts, Hostage Takers. But I don't think I really want to take any of those out. I don't know about Cavalier. I'm like a little worried of milling over too much stuff. But that's kind of silly though too. See, very good scry land here. I think last game was like, there's going to be times where the scry lands really hurt you. That's definitely going to be a thing. But I think last game was more of an anomaly of how much the scry lands hurt us than normal. I think they're going to help us. Especially there's just four of them in there.
That's more like it.
Good job, Nick. Way to go. Thoughts on Devkarin Lich? Devkarin Lich? I honestly do not know what Devkarin Lich does.
Let's skip to the good part. Don't worry, I got this. You just let me know if you're up for round two. We will meet again.
All right, just gonna get rid of the Time Raveler.
I won't hide from the world. Keep up the pace.
Because I was gonna be tapping out for sure, like the next turn, and
if I were you, I'd just surrender. Rise and shine.
Oh, Storev? Okay, yeah. I don't love Storev. I think you need to be like, Storev is the kind of card that I think you need to be playing a lot of creatures and planeswalkers for.
This is hardly my worst
defeat.
My army
has been destroyed.
I don't do this lightly.
Well, our only chance is finding Carnage Tyrant immediately and my opponent not having a Kai's Wrath for Carnage Tyrant. It's my only chance.
Only time will tell.
Right, it's going to be an extra draw.
I'm known for my excellent timing.
All right, so that's our Golgari Midrange deck. So like I said, this was a 5-0 list that looked pretty interesting that I wanted to try out, but I was not very impressed with this deck. Really, really wasn't. I don't know, I guess we never really had Assassin's Trophies, but you know, the deck's very, very slow, which of course I knew it was going to be, but Carnage Tyrant is our main win condition, and with these Esper decks just playing four Kai's Wrath's main deck, which like what they were, both the decks that we played against were doing that. The Carnage Tyrants just were not enough. They were not good enough. And our sideboard, Shifting Ceratops is okay, but I don't know. There's just a lot to this deck I didn't really like. I don't like not having Duress or Veil of Summer, and Deathsprout was pretty below average. Golgari Queen, it's okay, but like, and Cavalier Thorn's okay, but like these just don't seem to be like four of kind of cards that we have here. Liliana felt a lot worse than like what Ugin would be. Yeah, kind of would much rather have Ugin. Just didn't really have like good enough ways to like fight planeswalkers and stuff. I know we have those trophies, but I never drew trophy. I don't know. This just doesn't want, I don't know. This doesn't seem like where I'd want to be playing Golgari. Basically, there wasn't just like big enough spells. Like, you know, we don't have like Command the Dread Horde, Bola Citadel. We don't have like, there's some cards in the format that are just ridiculously powerful. Even like Nissa, and we're just not playing those. And I feel like that that's not a good place to be there. So there we go. That's Golgari Midrange. Basically, I think that there are more powerful cards in the format in these colors that we need to be playing. All right, so if you're watching the video later on YouTube, hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget to hit that like and subscribe buttons, of course, on YouTube. I'd appreciate that. But thanks for watching Golgari Midrange, and I will see you for the next video.